This is an auto-narrated audiobook generated by Google. Book The Tree of Wisdom by Nargarjuna. 1919. Preface. The Shirab Dong Bu, Tree of Wisdom, is a metrical translation in Tibetan of a Sanskrit ethical work entitled Prajnaya Danda, written by Nagarjuna, who flourished in the 4th century of the Buddhist era, about 100 BC. The Tibetan version was probably made about the 11th century of our era, but the exact date has not been determined. It is included in the Tengyur Go section, Volume Go, beginning at leaf 165. The Tibetan translator describes it as the second volume, but I cannot say whether the remainder of the work has been preserved in Tibetan. The Sanskrit original is apparently lost. When this work was selected as one of the textbooks for the higher proficiency examination in Tibetan, the Tibetan text was edited by the late Rai Bahadur Sarat Chandra Das and printed in continuous lines as is done in Tibet. This adds to the difficulties of the student, as there is nothing to show where one verse ends and the next begins. No English translation was prepared at that time, and the present attempt has been made with the object of assisting future students of Tibetan. The poem is known by name to the educated classes in Tibet, but few laymen appear to have read it, and fewer still to understand the many obscure passages. In the course of 2 years spent in Tibet, I sought the assistance of monks and laymen in and around Gyeongsi, but only succeeded in finding one elderly scholar who had read the poem. The abbot of the Palkor Monastery was good enough to make inquiries at Trashi Lunpo regarding the possible existence of a commentary on this work, but without success. By the courtesy of the Tibetan trade agent at Gansha, Kensheng Lobzang Chungya Lhotsawa, the printed text was compared with the xylograph edition forming part of the Tengyur collection in the Palkor Monastery, and a number of errors detected. It must, however, be added that the Palkor text does not appear to be absolutely accurate. All that can be claimed for the present edition is that it is more correct than the earlier printed text. A number of emendations have been suggested in the footnotes. Rai Bahadur Sarat Chandra Das remarked in his preface that the Shirab Dong Bu was largely quoted by Tibetan authors, but it is hardly quotation in the ordinary sense of the word. Later writers have borrowed many of the sentiments, and sometimes entire lines, inserting them in their own compositions. This is particularly the case in the Sakya Leg Shi, Sans. Subhashita Ratna Niti Nama Shastra, written by the celebrated Kun Ga Galtsen in the 13th century of our era, which is said to be a recafé of the works of three earlier writers on the same subject. I mention this here, as the works of Nagarjuna appear to have been not so much the subject of quotation as the source of extensive literary piracies. The present translation was made at Gyeongsi, but the number of passages to which no clear meaning could be assigned by the Tibetans was so great that I was in doubt whether it would be possible to proceed with publication, until I came to Gangtok and obtained the invaluable assistance of Kazi Dawa Samdup, headmaster, Bhutia Boarding School. Kazi Dawa Samdup had the advantage of receiving a scholarly explanation of the first 102 verses from a learned Lama Zheshi Kachan Tundrup of Shigatse, who studied the book some years ago and was accordingly able to give the meaning assigned by tradition to some of the passages which appear quite incomprehensible at first sight. The latter part of the translation was done without this special advantage, and some of the more difficult passages remain to be properly explained. The extreme baldness of the translation is intentional. I take this opportunity of recording my gratitude to the many Tibetan gentlemen who assisted me at the start, and above all, to Kazi Dawa Samdup, without whose assistance this translation would never have seen the light. Finally, I would acknowledge my obligation to the humble Sir Asutosh Mukherjee Sindh, the Calcutta University, who have undertaken the printing of the text and translation. W. L. Campbell. Gangtok, Sikkim. October 1918. The Tree of Wisdom. In the Tibetan language, the commentary of manners called the Tree of Wisdom. I do obeisance to the three deities. 1. Evil persons should be brought under control. The wise should be reverenced. Fill your treasury with honest deeds and protect your own countrymen. 2. As regards your own secrets and those of others, if you guard these as your own dear child, he for whom all earthly things are equal will make love for man the principal affection. 3. If your wife is evil and your friend evil, if the king is evil and your relatives evil, if your neighbor is evil and the country evil, then abandon them for a distant land. 4. Avoid that friend who is greedy for wealth. Avoid a wife who is fond of fornication. If unskillful in curing and hard to please or respect, avoid such a doctor. 5. Although you know the difference between good and bad deeds, you should carry out your work after consultation. Although you may only succeed partially, even without succeeding, you are to be admired. 6. The steadfast who speak in few words and politely are very much respected by mankind. As the sun which coming out from the shadow, by his rays creates great heat. 7.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.